Buckingham reflected that the young man, coming from Lord de Winter, undoubtedly spoke in his name, and softened.
"Without remorse," said he. "The baron knows, as well as myself, that Milady de Winter is a very guilty woman, and it is treating her very favourably to commute her punishment to transportation."
The duke put his pen to the paper.
"You will not sign that order, my lord," said Felton, making a step toward the duke.
"I will not sign this order. And why not?"
"Because you will look into yourself, and you will do justice to the lady."
"I should do her justice by sending her to Tyburn," said Buckingham. "This lady is infamous."
"My lord, Milady de Winter is an angel. You know that she is, and I demand her liberty of you."
"Bah! Are you mad to talk to me thus?" said Buckingham.
"My lord, excuse me. I speak as I can. I restrain myself. But, my lord, think of what you're about to do, and beware of going too far."
"What do you say? God pardon me!" cried Buckingham. "I really think he threatens me."
"No, my lord, I still plead, and I say to you, one drop of water suffices to make the full vase overflow. One slight fault may draw down punishment upon the head spared, despite many crimes."
"Mr. Felton," said Buckingham, "you will withdraw and place yourself at once under arrest."
"You will hear me to the end, my lord. You have seduced this young girl. You have outraged, defiled her. Repair your crimes toward her. Let her go free, and I will exact nothing else from you."
"You will exact,"
said Buckingham, looking at Felton with astonishment, and dwelling upon each syllable of the three words as he pronounced them.